Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue your streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. We did it, everyone. You all did it. Still continuing to crush the like streak. We may have to raise it up, man. After the random week, we might raise it up and go for something bigger and badder on the like streak goal. Thank you all very much. Sincerely, you have no idea how much it helps. Although probably most of you do, since you've watched me for at least 22 days now. It helps out more than you could ever possibly imagine. Here's your meme of the day. I went wholesome this time. This one brought to you by Narek J4. Yes, indeed. Nobody is born cool except for, of course, aww, little sissy. She's so cute and she loves you too. We love you too, sissy. You gotta love the wholesome sissy memes. I love that one. That one actually, it didn't make me laugh. It just brought a smile on my face. And honestly, that's more than I can ask for. Okay. See, today is going to be X-Ray 3, Mike Bravo, Mike 9, Hotel Sierra. We've got Ipecac, terrible damage, or a terrible movement speed. Kind of alarmingly low range for Ipecac, but we also have the coupon. Shot speed is also kind of low. So I guess the Ipecac APB is now canceled. Not that I'm not sure if we ever actually had one or not, but Ipecac, of course, is one of the better items in the game, in my opinion. It is definitely the quintessential highest damage that you can get up in the game, period. In terms of raw damage at one time goes, it doesn't get better than Ipecac. Nothing comes close to Ipecac's damage. Of course, you do have to have a little bit of caution whenever you use Ipecac, because it does indeed give you a moderately high potential for some friendly fire, namely on yourself. And the fact that we're also coupled with 47 tier delay is not great. And one of the things you're going to see right now, like for example, in this room here, is how dangerous it is to shoot whenever we've got. I might as well take the finger. I don't like the finger really, but given the fact of how much raw damage we've got thanks to Ipecac, we might as well try it. So yeah. And the reason why that's kind of bad that we have not great range right now and shot speed is because we do not have the movement speed necessary to keep ourselves safe, adequately anyway. Secret room is going to be right here. But of course, the upside to Ipecac, of course, is monster. I mean, just monstrous damage. You can very easily one-shot early game bosses. You can very easily take down other bosses without really having to worry about a care in the world. It's all about the friendly fire damage. How well you wield Ipecac is graded by how many times you hit yourself every single floor. And I've already hit myself once here, but that's because I was trying to wield the finger, which again is, I maintain, is not a, it's not an item that I actually like a whole lot, unless we have just insane raw damage like we do right now. And that's, again, courtesy of Ipecac. So the finger will deal invisible damage to anything that's within a straight line of your trajectory. So anything that we point downward at right now is getting just blasted by tons and tons of damage. The reason why I don't normally take the finger, however, is because you can technically, I guess, control the direction of the damage, you do not directly control when the damage actually hits. So in other words, we're getting tons of damage right now, but it's constant damage. And you might be thinking like, well, what's wrong with that? Well, the problem is that the damage also tends to blow up barrels and stuff. So you could inadvertently walk into a room next to, like, say, a bomb barrel that's right next to a bomb rock or something like that, and inadvertently knock yourself out, which is not fun. Super Secret Room's right there. By the power of logical deduction, I would really like either the battery or Mom's box of trinkets. So we have, or Mom's box of stuff. We can buy essentially two of these things to kind of, we can hopefully improve our odds of getting one of these two here. So I'm going to buy, let's see, I'll buy the key just because we don't need bombs, obviously. We have a 1 in 4 shot of getting something. Actually, we have a 50% shot of getting something that I want. And of course, the only reason why I wanted Mom's box of stuff was because I would get the cancer trinket for the tears up, but hopefully we get some help in that area. But it's hard to be sad about an Ipecac shot. especially with the way that the runs have been going so this week lately. I mean, we've had a ridiculous string of awesome runs. Like, just not even, like, bottom-of-the-barrel runs here and there. I mean, every single run this week has been an absolute banger. And except for maybe the Black Judas run, but that still ended up pretty good. So it is kind of nice to start off with an item that is, while relatively good, we still have a little bit of air of danger right now. Now, I'm not going to try to sit here and sandbag to you. Does Ipecac usually mean a one run? Yes, usually it does. But there are times where Ipecac doesn't always guarantee a one run, because, again, you have to take into account how much damage you're going to cause to yourself. How fast are you able to get away from your target? How fast can you create a little bit of a buffer area between you and whatever you're trying to shoot at, also known as your target? All that's very heavily dependent on Isaac's movement speed and as well as the shot speed of Ipecac. I'm going to take Liberty Cap here. Liberty Cap will give us the map compass, or will give us one of random compass effects, including the... Well, it will give us the compass effect every now and then, but it will give us one random mushroom effect, is what I meant to say. Trying to make sure that I don't hit myself against the wall here. I'm going to go ahead and give me a free entrance into the store. Again, PH Dizzle would be nice. I wouldn't turn it down. Now, you saw us actually destroy that fire there by having the finger just point at it, and that's kind of the damage that I'm talking about. Again, it's doing constant damage in front of us, whether we want it to or not. We just point in a direction, and then it just dies, as you see here with these barrels. So hopefully you get an understanding of what I'm talking about when I say you got to be careful with the finger. I don't normally take it. Blah, 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 blah. Hey, we got the mini-mush effect. Notice how we have a 23-tier delay instead of a 47. What? Book of Sin, of course, is going to be great for us. Book of Sin is always an amazing item. I will go clear this big room here as well, in case there are, you know, tinted rocks and stuff like that in there, which there is. And we get two bombs and a soul heart. Man, oh man. Wouldn't have it any other way. Also, yes, it's very weird how the tip of the finger is, like, super wibbly-wobbly. I'm not sure what's going on with that. I could actually destroy Fistula just by pointing the finger at it. We get Belly Button, which is going to give us an extra trinket slot. And we get the Stud Finder. Points it to itself. Beep, 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 beep. Whoa, we got ourselves a stud. Yeah. You know, I don't think this is a devil deal that we commit ourselves on here. Now, that's not to say that we're guaranteed we're not going to have a deal with the devil run here. But, I mean, I'm less inclined to take something like that. Whenever we have, of course, it helps that we have Ipecac, so. Thank you, Stud Finder. You will not be missed. We'll head on down to the next floor. What an excellent start to a run. Getting a lot of people telling me that they've been loving Isaac because of the streak. They picked it up after not touching the game in many years. That's awesome to hear. I'm really excited for the Legend of Bumbo as well. Some people agree with me with my Bumbo theory, some people not. That's okay. It's okay to disagree with people. Now, just because if you don't feel the same way that I do about a particular item or issue, you know what? I'm not going to hate you for it. And you shouldn't hate anyone else for that either. Some people said that Bumbo looks like it's going to be a little too slow. I can't really make any judgments until after I start playing the game. From the episodes that I've seen Ed play on YouTube, it's played very much like a match 3 puzzler, almost. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, by the way, Legend of Bumbo is the newest game coming out by the creator of The Binding of Isaac, as well as Super Meat Boy and some other classic indie games, Edmund McMillen. And that game is going to be coming out on the 12th. Of November, which I am super stoked for, because anytime and every time I can get myself a little bit of extra Isaac lore, I'm going to be happy. And it is set as a not a prequel, but it just predates the episode. It just predates the events of The Binding of Isaac. And I theorized yesterday, if you didn't catch yesterday's episode, I theorize that Bumbo has something to do or represents or is Isaac's dad. And for those of you who don't know the story of the Binding of Isaac, it's very open to interpretation. I mean, there's a lot of debate on what exactly is going on here. Is Isaac actually like being abused by his mother? Is he a druggie? You know, is he actually part demon? You know, it gets all whimsical and magical, and some are also more practical than others. But the general consensus that I've come up to is that Isaac is a very disturbed little kid who doesn't really, I guess, know his place in the world yet, but also is he's got some problems from a troubled upbringing. Let's put it that way. Yeah, that's... We need more movement speed to deal with that kind of things right there. Those kind of things. I don't believe that Isaac's mom's actively trying to kill him. I think that she is a terrible mother, of course. But I don't believe that she's actually trying to kill him. Maybe kill him with love. And he's rejecting that love in sort of a metaphorical sense, turn into a visualized sense some way. But I don't think that Isaac is a... I don't think he's a nice little boy either. I think that he also has a... he's got some troubling tendencies to get violent. But essentially, Isaac's dad has been out of the picture, and people have theorized that, you know, with the lack of a father figure can do that to a son and this and that. Of course, I'm no child psychologist, so I'm not going to talk about that kind of stuff. All I can say is that I do think that Bumbo will have some light shed on the father situation, and I'm interested to seeing how it goes. That would be really, really cool to have a new game that isn't canonically Isaac, but is still in the canon in the Isaac universe. You know, it's kind of like a side. It's a little bit of a side trek that was still was going to mix in some Isaac elements as well. Ed also tweeted out earlier this month about, it's actually earlier this week, that Legend of Bumbo is going to have over 200 items in it and combinations of attacks and spells. That's awesome. And he's excited. And whenever Edmund gets excited about Isaac stuff, I get happy because then it's like, yeah, dude, like I can't wait to just give us more Isaac. You know, what's the matter with more Isaac? And the game might come out, and the game might suck. You know, it may not be for me. It may not be for you. Maybe it's a big one for me, and I really, really love the game, and some people really hate it. That's fine. I'm still going to be covering it on YouTube no matter what. It's going to fill a nice little empty spot on the... I'm going to actually hold on to this gulp pill for now. Gulp, by the way, gives us the trinket smelter effect, which is Isaac simply just swallows the trinkets or they become a passive item. So we now passively generate extra flies, and we have the locus of pestilence as well, which is awesome. Super duper. Very super. I know what you're saying. It's Victa. Why are you taking... How come you're not taking the devil deals? Look, I'm trying. I'm trying to get you guys an angel run, okay? If the game doesn't give me the angel run, what can I do? I can't force it unless I get the Eucharist, which I don't have right now. But Legend of Bumbo is definitely going to fill a nice little niche spot that we've been missing on the weekends and on the off days of GeoGuessr, Tuesday and Thursday. So Bumbo, for now, whenever it comes out, it will be relegated to filling that time slot. So Tuesday, Thursday, and then on the weekends. Lobotomy Corporation will be unchanged. Take Trickle Charge, why not? I'm never actually convinced that Trickle Charge does anything, but we'll see. It's like I'm walking on Sunshine, it's going to be invincibility. And we're just cruising through this. The finger's actually doing real well. We get a curved horn drop. Wow. What a blessed trinket run, man. If we get the cancer trinket now, I'm like, I'm all, oh god. We can't. I cannot take Cricket's body. I can't. Not with Ipecac, not in this spot. Health up. I really cannot. Taking Ipecac at this stage, or taking Cricket's body with Ipecac with their already pretty bad base range is suicide. It is almost quite literal suicide. And you mix that on top of the fact that we have like god awful movement speed, it is just not a good idea. People have been sending a bunch of, where they hit us. They've been sending me a bunch of links to the metronome discussion, saying that we cannot actually activate Breath of Life from metronome. Apparently the wiki says that. I'll take everyone's word for it. It's not that I'm being dismissive. It's like, I just don't, like, I believe you. Like, I'll believe what you tell me until I need to look it up for myself. You know, I don't like spreading misinformation. We really don't need more HP. If we had explosion immunity, of course I'll take Cricket's body, but we just can't. Oh, we got another gulp pill. This is incredible. I've never seen so many gulp pills combined with so many awesome trinkets at the start of any run. If we get the cancer trinket and or cracked crown here, this is going to be like an amazing run for trinkets. I was trying to be sly there and drop a bomb in the middle of that path, that troll bomb. Didn't quite work out. Of course, you have to land that in order for it to really work. I'm excited about Bumbo. I'm excited about Pokemon Sword and Shield. People still asking me, am I going to be playing that game? Absolutely. Love Pokemon. Am I going to put any Pokemon content on YouTube? Now that's been the big question that I've been seeing a lot of people ask, and the honest answer is I don't know. It's not that I don't want to. It's just that with the way that Nintendo's YouTube policies go and all that stuff, that is knowing from what I know from my friends and coworkers who do content creation who have played Nintendo games on their channels in the past. I know that it is a very slippery slope of policies. Sometimes Nintendo claims stuff, sometimes they don't, sometimes they go, they say, oh, we support creators, or we love our creators, and sometimes they just don't. So, I don't know. The Phoenix Wright series is not, first off, again, it was never supposed to be a series. Secondly, they have not been claimed by anyone, which I'm pretty happy about, but I think that also Phoenix Wright is kind of a different beast altogether, no pun intended anyway, versus like a brand new Pokemon game. And of course the Pokemon game is going to be huge. I mean, everyone's going to be playing it. You know, so I will be playing Sword and Shield. I will be playing lots of it on stream. What gets transferred over to YouTube, I do not know. I don't have an answer for you all, and I apologize about that. But I really just don't want to deal with the headache and hassles of a very schizophrenic Nintendo behavior in terms of like how they treat content producers, and that was a great dodge right there. You know how they treat their content, and are they going to claim stuff? You know, and again, the problems compound the measure. They are compounded by the measure of the fact that if you do receive multiple content ID matches, you will just continue to get more and more. Like you're on the radar at that point for the system. So, and you don't want to be on the radar. As someone who was on the radar for many years, trust me, you don't. So I don't even want to deal with the hassle of possibly dealing with that again, because that was a very stressful time in my life. But one thing I will say though, to make sure that everyone is still, you know, I want to keep everything positive here. One thing I will say is that I'm very interested in producing some awesome battles and raids and stuff like that for Pokemon Sword and Shield. I'd be more than happy to bring that to YouTube if I can. If it looks like no one's having any problems with content ID matches and Nintendo kind of backs off of their somewhat wonky policy, then yes, I will be putting some stuff. That I hope to do so. Not going to guarantee anything, but I hope to do so. Because Pokemon Sword and Shield is going to be absolutely massive. And I think that everyone's going to want to see, like, you know, the random raid battles and who we squadding with, who, you know, which teams am I going to get now that we don't have the original what, the original three regions or so. People were asking about that too. Like, does it bother you if the new Pokemon doesn't have the old Pokemon? And the answer is no, I don't, because I don't even remember half of. I mean, everyone pretty much remembers the beginning 151 Pokemon. But everything after that, I don't know. I have no idea what generations they are. It doesn't. It all kind of blurs together for me. So, as someone who is a somewhat casual Pokemon player, but knows enough about video games and the series on the whole, I don't really. I'm not bothered by that at all. I'm like, yeah, it's not like I go out and I fill the Pokedex every single Pokemon game I've ever played ever. You know what I mean? Like, that's just like going through Monster Hunter and saying, yeah, I've got all the pieces of gear that I need in every single weapon of the game. You know, that might work for some people. That doesn't tickle my fancy in the special way, if you know what I mean. Go ahead and take Paperclip as well. Man, there's so many trinkets. Why are there so many trinkets? Does Belly Button do something to trinket drop rates or something like that? I've never seen this many trinkets, especially the good ones, drop this early. Usually we have to get through the boring and crap ones. Me the store here. Of course, I've got a stars card, and I'm looking at stealing the boss rush item. We will very easily make boss rush. But it's not rushing through anything, because we have a... Well, you see our movement speed. Yeah, we can go fight the lamb, why not? I don't know about victory laps, though. Oh, man. Serpent's Kiss Ipecac. Oh boy, brother. We got ourselves a fun time. Not only do we have the poison effect from Ipecac now, but we also have the poison effect from Serpent's Kiss. And I don't quote me on this, but I believe that the poison effects coincide with each other. So as long as we have Serpent's Kiss and we actually poison something with Ipecac, that will still count as being poisoned by Serpent's Kiss as well, I think. Now, despite us having PhD, we have not found any stat up yet, which is kind of amazing, other than HP, of course. Amazing in an amazing sort of way.
Invicto, why are you using bombs when you have Ipecac, you nerd?
What do we need 29 bombs for? We don't need any bombs. We got Ipecac. I think I'll be okay. I think I can get away with simply just using, like, you know, a bomb. By the way, we did not get a deal with the devil. Or deal with the angel. I'd like to point that out real quick here. Baby Bender, okay. Baby Bender for for little Steven, who we already have a homing shot with. Movement speed is my number one want. And we get a green fight. Alright. Well, this is a fantastic run. Started playing Red Dead Redemption 2 the day it came out. It's only the second game in history that I've purchased twice. The first game being Monster Hunter World. I've never ever bought a game twice. Especially if it wasn't like a sequel or a DLC. I mean, like, just straight up bought the same game twice. And it's not because I loved Red Dead Redemption 2 the first time it came out for PS4. I didn't play it enough for me to like it. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, wow, that is, like, the biggest waste of money of all time. I would say there's probably been bigger wastes of money of all time. And I'm not disagreeing with you. It was a waste of money on PS4. I thought that I was really going to get into Red Dead Redemption because at the time, as dumb as this might sound, I was also, like, super-duper hardcore into Westworld, the HBO series. But my love of Westworld quickly failed after this current season. I'm not going to spoil anything. Let's just say that Westworld sure does like hearing itself talk. Put it that way. And I just kind of got... I generally got kind of bored with the game, but it's only because it's the same thing that happens to me every single time I play a epic first person play, like RPG action open world, you know, adventure game, whatever have you, like Skyrim, like Red Dead Redemption, you know, anything like that. And it's just that if I have too much freedom, I don't know what to do, and that's where linearity in gameplay really strikes a chord with me, because I'm like, I'm not creative enough to create my own fun sort of thing. You know, I know there's this big, huge open world that I can go to. Oh, we can go get legendary monsters. We can go over here and get the best horse in the game. And, you know, we got new masks and that sort of thing. Like, that's great and all. But I kind of just want to, like, beat the game first and then go do the exploring thing. You know what I mean? So I get sidetracked very easily and to the point where I get lost because I don't know what to do next. And then I just get I don't get frustrated. I'm just like, eh, okay, this sucks. But, you know, like, I just lose interest, you know. But for PC, on the other hand, I am very interested. I was actually excited to hear that it was coming out for PC so soon. I don't keep up with Rockstar news or really any PC news for that matter. So I didn't even know that Red Dead Redemption was coming out for PC until very, very recently. I was like, oh, man, that's, like, right around the corner. So super stoked about that. And I played a little bit of it today, and it was great. It ran a little bit wonky, but I found out that the reason for it being wonky was due to OBS. Surprise, surprise there. But I think that I will be playing through most, if not all of it, because this time around, like, I don't know. There's something about the PC platform that feels more permanent to me than a console. It's hard for me. It really is hard for me to explain. I feel like the things that I do on the Monster Hunter version of the PC version of Monster Hunter World, I feel the things that I do there feel more permanent than they do on the PS4 version. It's more of an accomplishment because it feels more like it's mine. Like, it's not going to go anywhere. It's not tied to a box that, like, you know, is going to get outdated after a while. Like, the PC's feels a little bit more concrete, you know, a little bit more like it's going to stay around no matter what I do to it sort of thing. And that's how I felt about Red Dead when it was announced. I was like, oh, man, like, now I can finally play the game. You know what I mean? Like, no, meaning no disrespect to PS4s out there. The PS4 Pro, which is what I have right now, is one of the best systems I've ever had, period. If not the best console system I've had, period. I mean, it's solid. It's just that it's just a console for me in the end. I've PC gamed long enough to the point where I can't see myself doing it any other way. You know what I mean? And another thing that I will say is kind of a factor in all this, it is the fact that that PC games are much easier to stream and interact with people. Wow, we did not get a deal with the devil. We don't really need to go see Old Hushy. I think Old Hushy can wait. It's not that we can't kill Hush, it's that a Hush kill would take forever. If you notice that we have not gotten that many tears ups. In fact, we've only gotten one in the form of Mr. Squeezy. That being said, though, the finger does sort of take away a lot of the headaches of not having a good tears rate, so I will admit that. But yeah, I mean, I love my PS4. I love playing Monster Hunter on it. It's just it's so much easier and more integrated for me as a streamer, as a YouTuber, to have the PC be the main system that I stream, the main system that I do my gaming on and recording on. You know, it's just easier to work with. Instead of me having to worry about the capture card, you know, bugging out, and I gotta worry about sign-in details. I don't want people, you know, trying to find me on PSN network. And oh yeah, by the way, I don't have to pay for online play on a PC versus a PS4 sort of thing. That was the real kicker for me for Monster Hunter. I was like, excuse me? I gotta pay for a PlayStation Plus account so I can play Monster Hunter online with friends? Or since when? Because I can just fire up my Switch, or I can fire up my 3DS right now and play for completely free. The Switch might be that might actually be a lie. I'm not sure how they do their monetization. I don't really play Monster Hunter all that much with people, even with my friends. I guess I'm an antisocial gamer. I'm not antisocial. Like, I love meeting new people. I love talking to people. I love talking in front of crowds. I mean, that stuff's never bothered me. I like going out and just hanging out and, you know, people watching, with just meeting new people. Like, I'm all about that. But when it when it comes to gaming, I'm like, if someone wants says like, hey, Invicta, can we play with you? I'm like, 99.9% of the time, I get asked that a lot, and I'm just being 100% honest with you right now, as I always am. But every time that I hear someone saying, you know, hey, Invicta, can we play with you? Like, is there a chance we can play with you? The almost immediate answer is like, no way. Like, that, I don't want to play with anybody. You know, like, I've got a good thing going here. I know my own, I got my own system. I know exactly how, what my tendencies are. I can't get mad at someone else if I can just, if there's someone else in the game, you know, I can get mad at myself, and that's it. I don't have to worry about possibly passing the blame on others. It's the reason why I didn't want to play with anyone in Heroes of the Storm. It's not because I hate my fans. It's not because I hate people. I think I am just an introverted, antisocial gamer. Like, when it comes to multiplayer, anyway. I'm the exact opposite when the offer comes down for me to play with just random people. Like, the first thing that I do in, say, PUBG or any battle royale out there, H1Z1, you know, whatever have you, the Culling. First thing that I do, I turn off all microphone chat. I don't want to hear some rambling idiots on the microphone when I'm just playing this brand new game. You know, I don't know if that's a boomer way to say stuff. I mean, who freaking knows, man? You know what you like. I know what I like. I don't particularly care to playing with a whole lot of other people. Speed up. You don't know me like that. So we're going to take a Verp here, which is going to give us another speed up pill. Essentially, Verp makes you throw up the last pill that you took, and you get to take it again, but you maintain the benefit of having it. I don't know. That's just me, man. But I feel bad because I know a lot of people want to, like, a lot of people want to play Monster Hunter with me. A lot of people, they want to play Isaac with me. They want to do, you know, they want to play, if they hear me doing, like, a multiplayer game, they want to join me for that, and I'm flattered. It makes me feel really special and good that so many people just want to play stuff with me. And I feel bad because in almost every instance, I'm like, I just don't, you know what I mean? If something goes wrong, I can blame myself. I can write it off. I can be kooky and quirky and say, oh, the game's screwing me, you know? But as soon as I start playing with someone else, and like, let's say they actually are terrible. Like, take any game of Heroes of the Storm, for example. Let's say I was playing with a five. We were in a five stack large, going up, just randomly queuing up against random people, and I had a bunch of fans on my team. Let's say that they were, for the sake of argument, let's say that they were all legitimately just new or bad players, trolling or not trolling, whatever. They weren't up to speed. I would have a hard time controlling my frustration after a while, and I don't want to take that out on people because that's not a good look. It's not professional, and it's not something that I want to do. It's easy for me to blame myself, or easy for me to blame the faceless game that it's always the fault of. It's never myself because I'm the faultless streamer and the very good-looking and humble and very good-smelling YouTuber. But whenever there's someone else in the game and it's clear that they're not as good as I am, my brain instantly goes into, we were winning before this person joined us, sort of thing. You know what I mean? As someone who's very competitive, that's a dangerous mindset to be in, because then you start getting real nasty towards people, and you don't want to do that. And I've been better about doing that in multiplayer games, even in the times that we're playing with people I don't know. You know, I can control it for the most part, but it's hard to keep that frustration canned whenever, like, you know. Yeah, you got players who are just, they just want to have fun. They just want to be around you. They just want to have fun. And that's fine and all, but like, I'm also like, I kind of want to win, you know? That may sound brutally honest to some people, and that may give off the wrong impression. That's not my intention. All I'm saying is, I like to play multiplayer games and solo games the same. I like to play solo. Some people just have a hard time understanding that, which I respect.
That
Use a chariot card here. What time is it? 10:47? We could probably do a victory lap here. Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, enough about that rant. This run's been very good. If I can improve it in any way, what would I do? Give us a tiers rate, and more importantly, a shot speed upgrade. Our damage, of course, has been off the charts. We're about to get hit there. This is a different kind of broken. Oh, look at that. We get ourselves a 5-room. Now, I'm taking bets right now. Put them in the comments. Who's betting that Invicta forgets about the 5-room? Taking all bets. Anybody? Bueller? Nobody? Okay. I promise you, and I promise to the mosh pit, I will attempt to not forget about the 5-room. Get small rock, which does give us a speed down, but a tears up. You don't know me like that. Tears up. I'm gonna bring this one back. Eat, skirt. Luda. I love Ludacris. Oh yeah, we don't need that, Isaac. We already have the belly button. Yeah, the sack of sacks, whatever. Diplopia is very interesting. Especially if we get Steam Sale again. No, I'm not. I wouldn't take Steam Sale. I wouldn't break the game again. People are getting a little bit too crazy about it.
So tired of seeing Invicta break the game. Clearly manipulating the seeds.
You got me. By the way, the seed for this time around, the manipulated seed, Delta Yankee 4 Lima. You know what I wanted to say, but I decided against it. You know I wanted to say. Because sometimes, like, the nines and the leet speak can turn into A's, and it's kind of, you know, sometimes it's 4, sometimes it's 9. Oh, yeah, there's a rock there. We get a tears up here. Binky's going to be some monster tears up, and we're going to head on down the next floor. Just kidding. We're going to go back to the 5-room. Who lost their bet? Pay up. I want to see 35,000 new patrons tomorrow. That would be insane. if I had 35,000, that's an idea that I actually contemplated toying with, was just getting rid of all of my Patreon tiers except for the shout out tier and just drop everything to $1 and just to see how many people from my YouTube and from Twitch would carry over to that. I was like, man, if I can get 35, just like, if I can get half of the subscribers I have, even like a quarter of the subscribers I have to just give me $1 every month on Patreon, I would not have to worry about anything anymore. I mean, that's it. That would be insane. I seriously, we cannot take Rubber Cement Ipecac. I know the Zane is there, but again, We're talking in terms of actual suicide right now. Like, that is suicidal with Ipecac. Man, there's so many freaking... so many trinkets. But I did contemplate that. I was like, you know what? I wonder what would happen if I just simply did that. If I were to say, let's get rid of all my Patreon tiers and let's just do... a $1 tier, it's a shout-out tier, and let's see how many people I can get to come over there. I would be willing to bet that I would get a surprising amount of people. If the only tier that I have was just $1, I can see it happen. Apparently we don't have PhD, even though we still do, because Isaac's wearing the mask. Got ourselves Limehorn. We'll take Jesus Juice, it's a range up, it's exactly what we need. You know, I'll get rid of all the autograph stuff. I'll get rid of the album cover. I'll get rid of the cats. I'll get rid of the glasses and everything. And say, you know what? If you sign up for my Patreon for $1 or however many dollars you give, you get the shout out and my sincere thanks. No fuss. No mailing out stuff. No worrying about international shipping rates. I'm trying to talk myself into doing this because truly, that's what I want to do. But I don't know how practical it would be, though. There are days where I sit back and I think a lot. I do a lot of thinking about how I ended up here. There's so many things that had to. I'm not talking about my own existence, by the way. I'm not getting that philosophical on you. I'm saying how I ended up here on YouTube, how I ended up on Twitch. And it's free. It blows my mind, man. It is crazy. The number of events that had to go the way they did could only have gone one way for me to end up where I am right now. And that's insane. That really is insane. Even to this day, talking, like, just picturing 100,000 subscribers on YouTube just blows my mind. Eden Soul. Unfortunately, we can't use Eden Soul because we have. I mean, we can, but I'm going to hold on to Diplopia. Diplopia for the memes. Like, there's so many things that had to have gone perfect in the order of the. In the exact order that they did in order for me to be in this spot. And that keeps me, it doesn't keep me up at night, but it's fun to think about and reflect on stuff like that because it makes you truly, in my opinion anyway, it does for me, it makes me appreciate what I've got. And the scary world of YouTube and new media in general is a untamed beast. You know, new media can taketh and new media can giveth. Just as fast as it began, it can end. And that's, you know, terrifying to some people. That's why I'm in the business of just keeping my head low, keeping my nose to the ground, and just minding my own business and doing my own thing. You know, I've got lots of opinions on things that differ from a lot of my friends. Not all of them, but some of them. You know, I just differing opinions. You know, I've got opinions on stuff that some people may not be too excited about, but I stay out of all of it. You know, it's not me to just share my opinion for no reason at all, especially if it's not asked for. Wouldn't mind turning into Lazarus II, by the way, here. If you're wondering why we were getting items from that angel statue, go way, way, way back to when I first started picking up all these trinkets. One of the trinkets that we have is a filigree feather, which will give us a random angel item if we encounter an angel statue instead of a key piece. Now, we do have one key piece, and I wouldn't mind fighting Mega Satan here. So, but I also kind of want to see what other items we can get with this trinket. I guess we'll go Magic Scab. Gives us a luck upgrade. No, I like keeping to myself and I let the videos and the work ethic do the talking for me. You know, grinding away day in and day out. And I couldn't be happier. And man, oh man, I want to bring. I'm so looking forward to the day that I can bring you all along with me, in the house. Whenever I eventually get one. The back of my brand new recliner. I might even have a beer. Who knows? I haven't drank beer in many, many, many years. Man, I haven't. I've been. I truly do not remember the last time I had an alcoholic beverage. It's been a very long time. And which is insane because like I used to drink like a lot when I was a bartender, man. Like I used to drink all the time. Not to a problematic degree, but I mean I was a social drinker, you know, working, I'm drinking. If I'm not in class, I'm drinking. Partying, oh yeah, you bet your butt I'm drinking. But eventually, you know, after you get past, you know, 55, 60 years old, you just kind of get bored with it after a while. not really bored. It depends on your, I mean, I was never a huge fan of drinking in the first place. I could always take it or leave it, let's put it that way. Yeah, we can open that. I mean, we've got the master lock picking. No beer? As I got older, I mean, I don't mind the taste of beer. I used to hate it. I used to think it just tasted awful. But I kind of became okay with beer. Being of legal drinking age, of course. Which I only just now passed. I could be making all this up, you just never know. That's the beauty of it all, man. And some people take advantage of that. They really do. You hear a lot about people reinventing themselves when they go into high school, or when they graduate college, or even when they graduate high school and go off to college. You hear people reinventing themselves. Let me tell you something. If you don't think that happens on the internet, whew, brother, sister, I got myself a nice shiny rock here that keeps tigers away. I'd love to sell you for hundreds of dollars. Actually, it was bears, but you know. No, it wasn't bears. Lisa's rock kept tigers away. Me arguing with myself, my inner Simpsons monologue. The point is, there's people that I know in real life that are just not like how they wish to be themselves, how they perceive themselves to be acting it or portray themselves as online. No, I'm not taking experimental treatment. Oh my goodness gracious. Is this a diplopia time? I think it is. You know why? Because watch this. Well, first off, let's destroy the angel statue first. Okay. For some reason we didn't get an item, that's fine. Watch this. We're gonna use diplopia. And then we're going to use void. And yes, your eyes are not seeing that. The item's stuck there. I do want halo, though. But the problem is that if I take the halo back there, the other ones will disappear. If I take this halo, all the other objects stay here. Or I could just void them all. Take one halo. I'll take one halo. And I'll take one key piece. Let's go. Sure, external treatment, why not? Gives the tears up. Kind of a big damage down, but whatever. Unless I was standing inside of Succubus, which I think I was anyway. And no, we won't be taking... Oh my god, our shot speed. What in the world? This is insane. You talk about super finger build. This is it right here. Hey, there's a double tinted rock in here. This rock right here is a double tinted rock. Again, as you notice, the lighter colored X towards the middle of the rock, that is different than a regular tinted rock, which would be darker and more off to the side. And no, because it inevitably always comes up whenever I get void and diplopia. No. Voiding diplopia does not give you the diplopia effect every time you use void. I believe it did when void first came out, but that was very quickly patched by Nicholas. Yeah, they did not like that one bit. It was just too easy to break the game. That, I mean, like, out of all the balance changes, that is one of the ones that I'm like, yeah, I understand that, you know? Like, the undefined change, I will still never know. Like, that still feels like the most anti-player FU change that we've seen in Isaac. The Dark Bum change, it was hard-hitting, but it was fair. The Krampus' head change was, in my opinion, just kind of weird. I didn't think Krampus' head was that big of a deal. But apparently it was super overpowered. And then they made it twirl, which made it even worse. But the undefined loop in the chest itself definitely was... That was the turning point for me for thinking, like, okay, we're starting to take a little bit more than just... We're starting to take a little bit more than just, like, player feelings into account here for the balancing changes. I'm not insinuating anything, but that one still stings because that was something that I did a lot of, was look for undefined, you break the game, you go to the chest, and you just have a ball. It's just fun, you know, it's just fun. It's harmless fun. But a change like stopping Diplopia from being copied by Void every time you use Void is certainly warranted. And to a begrudging degree, I will say that the Krampus's head change is understandable. I'm not going to take tears up yet because we might get placebo or we might not. Plus, we're already at the tears cap anyway. So we got compost. We're going to take compost. I'm going to take void. We're going to void compost. And then we're going to use compost again. Which I don't actually think worked, but I'm going to pretend it did anyway. You can see that tinted rock there. Gonna be Gish. Gish is dead. Like Synthoil here for Spun. No, we didn't get Spun yet. Glyph of Balance is quite bad. Makes you think that it's Libra, but it's not. Get the Mind, which is awesome. What a run. It just makes me happy, you know. It just makes me happy to think how far we had to travel to get to the point we are right now. You know, I see other people. I made it no secret that I follow people like Markiplier. In more recent years, Mr. Beast. I've been liking a lot of his videos. Not all of his videos, but most of his videos are at least entertaining. And if you follow Mr. Beast on Twitter, he reminisces a lot about, you know, he's only 21, which is insane because that's only a couple years older than I am. But dude's got like 20 million subs. And what's crazy is that he tweets about like how he hasn't like I think 2 years ago in a recent tweet he said. He had his first like million or 2 million subs or something like that, and then less than 2 years later he's got like 20 million, and I'm like, man, I don't know if I would ever want my channel to be that big. Unironically, I mean that, because I'm sitting here I'm still over the world. I mean, 100,000 still hasn't sunk in. I have to pinch myself sometimes thinking like, are we really here? Do we really have 100,000 subscribers on YouTube? That's insane, man. How did we get to here? Like, that doesn't seem right. Oh my god, what is going on with these freaking items? We don't need any more damage. The wafer is guaranteed goodness. I'm going to take the wafer, and then I'm going to fight the statue so we can get an item here. The wafer is going to have all of our damage. The Spear of Destiny. I only took it just because people want to see it whenever they see it, so... Yeah. I don't want the D5, really, I'm going to be honest. You know, and someone like Mr. Beast, who is a YouTube powerhouse at this point, you know, still feels that way about 20 million subs versus his previous 2 million. Here's Spun, by the way. And I'm like, man, it like every day is my birthday right now. Ever since hitting 100,000 subscribers. Like, that was one of the biggest days of my life. And as dumb as that sounds, as hokey as that may seem, I still hold that with the highest level of proudness. And I'm not proud of stuff that I do very often. You know, I don't ever... You never hear me boast about, you know, oh, that was a really, really good video that I did or something like that. You know, occasionally I'll compliment myself, but it's never something that you hear me actively take part in. I don't self-gloss. That's not how I was raised, but it's just not how I ended up being. I think that if you start complimenting yourself, you start getting a little too uppity about big things, and you miss the little things that can end up hurting you. I think that you start getting complacent. If you start getting complacent, that's bad, because then you start settling for less, and you never try to improve on stuff. That's how I feel about that. That's why for me, it feels like there's nothing, nothing's ever good enough because I want to keep on improving. And taking 7 years to get here at 100,000 subscribers is a long journey, but honestly, wouldn't have it any other way. I don't want to be any bigger. Oh my God. I don't want to be any bigger than I am right now. I'm happy to grow organically. I'm happy just to see it all, how it all transpires. I'll take chaos because why not at this point? We've got Poly freaking Venus. The amount of damage that we do in this run is absolutely absurd. And it's been like this since the word go. Pokemon Go. Right now I'm trying to angle the finger to do some monster-sized damage here to Blue Baby. Maybe Hush Baby. This isn't actually Blue Baby. I don't know. I'm not sure if this boss has ever been identified. It might just be all considered Hush at this point. I'm not sure. Like a delirium sort of thing. Now, what's nice about the finger is that it does kind of chip away at Hush's super armor a lot faster than if he didn't have it. Since it's like constant damage there, you're constantly kind of... It's death by a thousand cuts via the finger, so to speak. Even though we're doing tons of damage for our regular shots, Hush's super armor is mitigating a large portion of that, but because we're hitting him constantly with the finger, it's less noticeable that he even has protection right now. Thought I was going to be able to thread the needle there. Turns out, I was not. What a fun run, though. What a great run. Had lots of fun discussion topics. Had ourselves a super-powered Isaac run. Wasn't even close in terms of, like, the overall, like, wonder of, you know, are we going to win this one? Hey, we didn't break the game this time. I mean, we were broken in a different way, I suppose. Broken by damage, I guess. But the Polyphemus CAC is extremely potent. And then you combine that with a damage aura of Succubus. Oof. Brings a little nerd tingle to your face. It's like, man, I don't want to get hit by that. Unfortunately, we can't stop Hush from doing his normal thing here. Which is annoying because Hush always does this whenever he's getting beaten badly. He will sink into the ground for another minute or two just to waste everyone's time. Very happy to report that I did beat Coach Crendor Fantasy Football. I'm also number one in our pick'ems now for our football podcast that I do with Rob and Coach Crendor and occasionally Bear. It's been fun seeing that channel grow, even though, you know, well, Rob and Bear don't really do YouTube anymore, but even though Crendor and I, more so Crendor than myself, are established YouTubers now, or at least, I don't want to say established, because that sounds disrespectful to Bear and to Rob. Let's say active. Even though we're both still active on YouTube, it still feels neat to see our first 1,000 subs happen. And then, like, we've enabled ads now, so we're actually making money on our stupid little football podcast. You know what I mean? Like that's stuff that, like, it's a weird feeling. It's a great sense of accomplishment and pride to see those little milestones. And the same thing holds true whenever I'm talking about my channel for the subs, man. And I have you all to thank for that. No one else. I'm getting really lucky with these angel deals. Well, angel statues, anyway. That is so much damage. That is just a redonkulous amount of damage. We're going to go fight Blue Baby here, see if we can finish out the full house run. Oh my God. What is this craziness happening here? Okay, so we got a long way to go. But honestly, I don't even think I need to do anything here. I'm pretty sure the finger and, like, one fly is going to be more than enough. And remember, we're spawning more flies here thanks to the Locust of Pestilence. And also remember, if I do end up using Void, that doubles all of our current flies and spiders because of compost. So you can imagine how much damage we're doing. Times that by a whole lot. How's Gertie Sr. dying in one fly? Yeah. No delirium portal. Well, we've got only one shot left. I don't know why Delirium's been... He's been so... hidden lately. Seems like we can't even buy a Delirium portal these days. And of course, I could go into it from Hush, but... shot speed is ridiculous. Alright, let's see if Mega Stanley can hook us up here. The damage of our Bob's rotten head was enough to send Mega Staten over the edge in less than a second. This is just madness. It's been a while since we had a run this powerful. I'm not talking about broken powerful, I mean like just straight up damage. Like we didn't break the game to get this damage, in other words. Right now I'm standing at the back of the screen, and we're still able to hit him. The shot speed is ridiculous, 2.28. Remember, the finger is also dealing constant damage to him, as long as we're pointing in that direction. Down goes Stanley. And again, Delirium denied. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. Thank you all very much for destroying that like streak goal every single day. This week and last week, still counting as we move towards 30 and towards win number 600 coming up, hopefully within the next day or two.